In this video, I'll show you how to handle keyboard and mouse input events with the Win32 native library, including storing the keyboard state and tracking mouse movement and buttons. The code and build script can be downloaded from the text version of this tutorial, linked below. To compile, we need to link to GDI32. Note that I'm compiling this code with GCC and not Microsoft C compiler. To compile with CL, you'll need to remove the print error macro and also link to user32. This code includes the usual Win32 window setup code currently highlighted. I'll collapse that away for the rest of the tutorial and focus just on the input code. We have a 256 element Boolean array to store the state of each keyboard key, with false meaning not pressed and true meaning pressed. This mouse structure stores the cursor position within our window and the state of the standard mouse buttons, which Windows considers to be left, middle, right, X1, and X2. I made this enumerator to assign each of these buttons to a different bit, which is how we can store all 5 buttons in a single byte in the structure. We can handle all 4 keyboard events in one block of code. If our window has focus when it processes the event, we check the current and previous state of the key by extracting the 31st and 32nd bits of LPRAM. We do this to ignore key repeat events, where you hold down a key and after a few seconds it starts sending repeated key events. WPRAM stores the key index, which we use to set the corresponding element in the keyboard array to the new value. This results in an automatically updating array holding the keyboard state. I've also demonstrated how you could use a switch statement to immediately respond to the press of any keys here. Latching the keyboard events like this does cause the issue that, if you press and hold a key, tab out of the window, then release the key, you won't receive a key release event, so in your application the key will still be considered pressed. That's why in many older games you can tab out, then when you tab back in find that your character has walked straight over a cliff. To solve this, we clear the keyboard array whenever we receive the WM kill focus event. We can also use this hasFocus variable just because window can in some circumstances send you keyboard events even when your window doesn't have focus. In the main program loop, we can check the state of any key using the virtual key codes listed in Microsoft's documentation. Here I'm checking the WASD and arrow keys to move a dot around the screen. Mouse input uses a few more events. WM mouse move tells us the position of the cursor relative to our window, where the top left is 0, 0, and the bottom right is width minus 1, height minus 1. X and Y are the low and high 2 bytes of LPRAM. Since our drawing code uses the opposite y-axis, we subtract the mouse y-coordinate from height minus 1 to invert it. Here we handle the left, middle, and right mouse buttons. When they're pressed, we use bitwise OR to set the correct bit in the mouse dot buttons byte to true, and on release we bitwise AND the inverse to set the correct bit to false and leave all the other bits as whatever value they already were. The X1 and X2 buttons are handled from the same WM X button down and up events, and we extract whether it was X1 or X2 from WPRAM using the Get X button WPRAM macro. In the mouse wheel event, the scroll direction is stored in the 32nd bit of WPRAM. Like the keyboard, whenever the window loses focus, we set mouse stop buttons to 0. In the main program loop, we check if the left button is pressed, then set the pixel at the mouse position to white. Now when we run the program, we get 2 white dots, one that zips around as we use WASD or the arrow keys, and another which only appears when holding the left mouse button. That's how to handle input with the Windows native library in C. In my next tutorials, I'll show you how to play real-time audio, load and play sound files, and load and display images. Cheers!